Hello all. In this session, we are going to solve a numerical problem on coplanar concurrent force system. Here I have taken one example, that is, for this, find the magnitude and direction of the resultant of the coplanar concurrent force system, which is shown in the figure. So here we have four forces in a system, that is, 10 kN, 20 kN, 52 kN and 60 kN. So, except the 10 kN, all the other three forces are inclined forces. So, inclined forces we need to resolve into two directions, that is, one's for horizontal and one's for vertical. Okay. So, before going to solve the problem, first we need to know the forces sign convention, that is, the forces which is moving rightwards, we are taking as positive, and leftwards we are taking as negative, upwards taking as positive, and downwards we are taking as negative. So this is a sign convention to solve the problem. Okay, let R be the given resultant force system and alpha be the angle made by the resultant with respect to x direction. The magnitude of resultant force is given as R is equal to root of summation of fx whole square plus summation of fy whole square, and alpha is equal to tan inverse of summation of fy divided by summation of fx. So before going to solve the resultant force, first we need to know the summation of all the horizontal forces and also summation of all the vertical forces. Okay, here you can see, as I said, all the forces are inclined except the 10 kN force. So first we need to resolve these forces. This 20 kN is going to resolve once for x axis and once for y axis. Same way, 52 is going to resolve for y once and x once. Again, the 60 kN is going to resolve for x and once for y without changing its direction. You can observe the arrowhead here. So without changing the direction. So here, how to take the angle for this? In the easiest way, say for example, this is angle is here. So 20 kN, if it is acting along the angle, so we are considering it as cos theta. And if it is acting away from the angle, so this is we are taking sine theta. Right, same here also, 52 and 60. Okay, here summation of fx, that is 20 cos 60 degree, 52 is moving leftwards, so minus 52 cos 30 degree, and 60 is moving rightwards, towards right, so this is 60 cos 60 degree, and 10 kN, as usual, it is directly moving rightwards. So this is plus 10. So the total is summation of fx is equal to 7.404 kN. And next, summation of fy, that is all the vertical forces. Here we have, we'll get three vertical forces, that is one with 20 and one with 52 and one with 60. Two forces are upwards, that is plus, and one force is downwards, that is minus. Here, 20 sine 60 degree plus 52 sine 30 degree, this is all the forces are upwards, and minus sine 60 degree, right? So the total is summation of Fy is equal to minus 8.641 kN. So this is a way of finding summation of Fx and summation of Fy. So now we are going to solve with the resultant force. That is, R is equal to root of summation of Fx whole square plus summation of Fy whole square. If we substitute both the values, we'll get R is equal to 11.379 Newton. Next, alpha is equal to tan inverse of summation of Fy divided by summation of Fx. So here again, we need to substitute fy divided by fx, that is minus 8.641 divided by 7.404. So the final answer is minus 49.40 degree. So we'll get the alpha here. So after this, we need to fix the resultant force in a quadrant, that is, so we need to take the quadrant system here. So we need to see the horizontal force and vertical force values, that is, vertical force is positive. We'll see the answers. Okay, horizontal force is positive and vertical force is negative. So for this, we need to draw the quadrant system here. That is, horizontal force is positive and vertical force is negative. Therefore, resultant force lies in this, that is, fourth quadrant. So this is a way of solving and fixing the resultant force. And also we need to write the alpha value here. Okay, so we got R is equal to 11.379 Newton and alpha is equal to minus 49.40 degree. We'll move on to the next problem. That is, determine the magnitude and direction of the resultant of the coplanar concurrent force system, which is shown in the figure below. Here also you have four forces: 200 Newton, 75 Newton, 100 Newton and 150 Newton. So all the four forces are inclined here. So we need to resolve this. That is, once for horizontal, once for vertical. This will become 200 cos 30 degree. This is 200 sin 30 degree. Next, 75 horizontal and vertical. This is 75 cos 70 degree. This is 75 sin 70 degree. Next, horizontal, vertical. So 45 cos 100 degree. Sorry, 100 cos 45 degree. This is 100 sin 45 degree. Next, again, this is also once for horizontal, once for vertical. This is 150 cos 35 degree. This is 150 sin 35 degree. Okay, here the assumption, that is, let R be the given resultant force system and alpha be the angle made by the resultant system with respect to x direction. The magnitude of the resultant, as usual, R is equal to root of summation of fx whole square plus summation of fy whole square, and alpha be the tan inverse of summation of fy divided by summation of fx. So here summation of fx is equal to 200 cos 35 degree, which is moving rightwards, and minus 75 cos 70 is negative leftwards, and minus 100 cos 45 degree is also moving leftwards, and plus 150 cos 35 degree, which is moving rightwards. Next, fy also same way, 200 sin 30 degree plus moving upwards, plus 75 sin 70 degree, minus 100 sin 45 degree, minus 150 sin 35 degree. So the total is fy is equal to 13.72 Newton. So here you can see in the figure two positive and two negative. So here you can see the vertical forces, two upwards and two downward forces. Okay, so substitute with the R, that is, R is equal to root of this one. So if you substitute, we'll get R is equal to 200.21 Newton. Alpha is equal to, so we'll get, if you substitute, tan inverse of 13.72 divided by 119.72, we'll get 3.93 degree. So this is a way of solving the problem. And when we are fixing this resultant force, take the quadrant system, and fx is positive, fy is also positive, so resultant force lies in first quadrant. So also alpha is equal to value and R is equal to value, we need to mention. So this is the way of solving. fixing the resultant force in the coplanar concurrent force system. Thank you.